Here we go again, back with more Pro Cycling Manager Season 2016 and Stage 7 of this year's Tour de France. Today we have the first mountain stage of this tour. It's the first Category 1 climb as well, from L'Isle Jourdain to Lac de Payolle. It's downhill, but it's a very difficult Category 1 climb just before that. I'll try and put one of my better climbers, either Reichenbach or Morbito, in the breakaway. Then we'll see what happens from there on out. Okay, last 20 kilometers here. I have Steve Morbito from my second best helper rider and second best overall rider in the breakaway here. He's by far the best climber here. He also has a pretty decent day, which is why I picked him over Reichenbach, who's now been left foot protected in Thibaut Pinot. We're nearing the climb now. I'm hoping I can get a stage win with him. Else, I don't know, maybe just stay him in the front group, so I'll have two riders at least near the top of standings here. I think he'll get that anyway, because he has a head start on the rest of the favorites here. But here goes the start of the climb. 12 kilometers long, 6.6. Col d'Aspin, a pretty famous climb. It's been used a lot of times, actually, in the Tour de France. I'll just try now. Maybe should I attack immediately here? See if I can gap the rest. Maybe Thomas Fuclair is one of the few riders here who is capable of following me for a while. But I don't think he'll be able to follow me for that long. Just quickly get the bottle of water here. Let's look at the Pels and see. Pinot is still pretty well placed. Reichenbach ahead of him. He didn't get water in time, which is a bit sad. Anthony Rojo's going to get water is not going to get up here. I can already tell that the pace is really high right now, because now we've entered the final climb. Froome, Contador and everybody else are all sitting here at the moment. Let's just take a look up front here. Morbito slowly driving away from Thomas Fuclair. I don't think Fuclair will be able to hold his pace for that long. I think he'll be dropped pretty soon. But 8 is also a bit too much, I think, for me. So I'll push it a bit down to 70. Probably make him stay there for a bit longer, but I think that's a sacrifice I can make for now. There's only 14 kilometers to go. Or 13 kilometers to go, anyway. Try and attack here again. Let's see if he has the power this time to keep up with me. I don't think he has. Okay, I've gotten away from him. Will this be Francis Dussault's first stage win? Fuglas done. So now I think it's all about managing energy with Morbito up front here for the stage win, and then just keeping an eye on Pinot behind us here to ensure that he's still staying with the front of the group here, not losing too much energy. We have an attack here. Rodriguez, Bakke-Mollema, Quintana, Valverde staying back in his yellow jersey, letting his teammate close the attack. Contador, Bardet, I think that is moving along as well. So Sky now have to move up. It's Froome and Mikel Landa, Jon Thomas, all the strong tight Sky team. Hinao is there, Wout Poels. Oh, they're going up fast. They're catching me fast right now. I don't like that. Valverde going, Nibali, Rohan Dennis, Richie Porte is still back here. It's Bakke-Mollema now going solo. Oh, this is going to be very difficult for Steve Morbito to stay away now. I'll have to up the pace a lot. There's still 3 kilometers to the top. I think I'm going to get caught here by Bakke-Mollema and whoever the favorites is down here. Pinot seems pretty strong today, but Mollema and Contador in particular, in my belief, are going fast. Also the two Sky riders here and Quintana. But it's Bardet, Nibali, Fuglsang, Richie Porte, Valverde, Bagil. It's a smaller and smaller group, and fewer riders are making it up here. 1 kilometer to the top. This is also pretty sure going to... I don't have any points in mountain classification, otherwise I would have probably won the mountain jersey by this. But I of course did not. Is that Froome coming here at the end here, trying to steal the mountain points and the leader's jersey after the stage here? Oh, can I stay with the group here with Bardet? Oh, I just missed it again, didn't I? Can I get up to Richie Porte? Oh, thank God I made it. This is such an important group to make in, because otherwise I would have lost more and more time on a downhill here. Going to protect Pinot here just to make sure he regains energy on the downhill here as fast as he possibly can. Okay, he's regaining energy. That means he's staying in the group. It means the pace is slow enough that he's actually staying here. That is so important for me right now. Let's see what we can do here now. Thibaut Pinot, go on the wheel of... Nobody, at least, I think so. Okay, I just moved up ahead here. Let's see how much attack sprint we have. I think Valverde should be the favorite for this sprint here. But I started with the head start here. Did I tactically... No, I did. I just thought I tactically outmaneuvered them. But instead I just got overtaken. And I think it's a 1-2-3... Oh, I thought that's Valverde. Just ahead of Hinault, Froome takes third and a bit of bonus seconds. Hinault actually celebrating his second place finish. That must be embarrassing. But we got two riders in the top 10, I believe. Morbidelli finished fifth after a long breakaway, and Pinot in the front group finished eighth. So I think we should have moved up a bit in the standings here. At least all of these guys here we finished ahead of. So that's a decent start, but I'm a bit worried that we had such troubles even hanging on. Minus one day. I think once we get a good day, hopefully tomorrow, then we'll do a lot better. And that was the end of stage 7, the first mountain stage. Nibali loses 14 seconds in the end, just getting dropped in the sprint. Valverde defends his yellow jersey in the best way possible, taking a stage win. I have my best two riders in the front group, which was a pretty good result. Impressed by Morbidelli, managing to stay away, almost getting a stage win, but he just couldn't keep the chasing peloton away from him. At the final climb, I'll probably try and put like Reichenbach in a breakaway, since I think he's more likely to get in a breakaway and be allowed to stay away now. Overall classification looks as follows now, almost in the top 10. I'm pretty sure these are the 10 riders actually in the group with me. And of course, the 12th guy was, what's it called, my own teammate, Steve Morbidelli. So these are probably the 11 riders I'm going to be battling with for top 10 finishes and maybe more, but for now, we could be doing a lot better. Having lost 2:29 already after the first mountain stage is not a great start. Tomorrow is, I believe, the first proper mountain stage with a lot of climbs during the day. Called Tourmalet, Père Soud, I believe it is, the final climb, but it ends downhill just as last stage. Hopefully we'll do even better and we'll be in great shape for tomorrow's stage. Let's cross our fingers for that. But that's it for now. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please consider leaving a like, commenting and subscribing. And I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.